This movie is a freewheeling take on visionary inventor Nikola Tesla, his interactions with Thomas Edison and J.P. Morgan's daughter Anne, and his breakthroughs in transmitting electrical power and light. First of all, this biopic is not really your standard biopic. It doesn't care to play by the rules. The movie escapes the shadow of focusing on different time periods by leaning entirely into the artifice. It's not uncommon for the movie to break into a slideshow of Google searches. It's not all that surprising when Kyle MacLachlan's interpretation of Thomas Edison whips out his iPhone, or that Jim Gaffigan seems to have just walked on set to play George Westinghouse. Scenes are created using painted backdrops and often take place in bars or modern bistro spots, as if parodying one's expectation for how such historical scenes should be recreated. The movie works through different life sequences as if it were a musical. This looseness provides a strong contrast to the dialogue-driven script. Unfortunately, this creative choice is really baffling. The movie proves to be a completely liberated biopic, so much so that it's out of reach. Ethan Hawke, who plays Tesla, mumble whispers his way through the notoriously introverted Tesla, not taking even a stab at a Croatian accent. Couple that with a generally inferior supporting cast, especially when compared with the all-star Oscar bait of A Current War, and you've got this much worse of two movies involving Tesla's story. It's obvious that the director worked with a low budget on this movie. In many scenes, the size and detail of each set is minimized to just simple rooms, whereas the exteriors are often done with a clear painting or green screen as a backdrop, with the actor standing in front. The lighting gives away the painting as a flat surface, and the filmmakers make no effort in hiding them, almost like it's all intentional. But this movie just doesn't feel experimental enough. Its aesthetic choice doesn't really have a narrative purpose. The film cannot decide what it's aiming to do in terms of story and commentary. This movie never has a clear agenda or end goal. The screenplay and pacing also falters. It's not really talking about Tesla, or his rivalry with Edison, or about the industry, or even the country at the time. It flirts once or twice with the idea of idealism versus capitalism, but it never fully commits to picking a side or making a point. For this reason, the screenplay feels like a bunch of quirky scenes too dedicated in its documentary style and not invested enough in actual character development and story growth. None of the movie aspects build on one another and are stitched together unevenly, which deeply affects the pacing. In the end, this movie feels like style over substance matter, without enough effort to tell the story about the life of Nikola Tesla.